this out. I am going to show you 12 concepts, transform tips in just 2 minutes. Number one, go into settings under gestures and set tap and hold to either lasso or item picker. Now, if you hold your stylus to the screen, the lasso or item picker tool will appear. I recommend this when designing because it will allow you to quickly make selections to edit with minimal movement of your stylus while drawing. That brings us to tip number two. You can actually go into your settings and make one finger the selection tool. Despite the overlap in function, I typically like to have this set as well as tap and hold because the select function is just so stinking useful. Tip number three, with a line selected, tap and hold the L in the upper right hand corner to enter the exact length. Tip number four, with the measure tool, tap and hold the dimension callout to enter an exact length. Tip number five, use a Bluetooth keyboard or magic keyboard to speed up entry of exact dimensions. Tip number six, set four finger tap to select last to quickly modify line work once drawn, which is great for entering precise lengths right after you've drawn the line. Tip number seven, if a line was drawn with 100% smoothing, you can quickly move the entire line with the nudge tool. This is cool because you can pick up and drop the ends of your lines where you want. Tip number eight, with an item selected, you can change the line type, the color, or the opacity, and it'll only affect the selected item. Tip number nine, modify your transforms by tapping the nodes on the selection box. This is great for skewing or picking up 2 points or even anchoring from a single point. Tip number 10, before you make a selection, you can actually double tap on the layer to turn on focus, and then that'll allow you to make a selection that filters just for that layer. Number 11, when items are selected, you can filter to the active layer by tapping the filter button in the context at the menu at the bottom and switching from all to active. Number 12, turn on snap to key points and snap options to snap lines to key points like endpoints and midpoints, and this is a great way to make drawings that are ready for DXF export. We'll cover this in the next video as soon as that is ready, which will be available right here, and that's going to be all about how to take your drawings from concepts to AutoCAD.